So guys, in this video, I just wanted to discuss with you about, you know, NiFi databases. So as you know, all the applications store its database, store its application related data somewhere in the database. So NiFi by default uses H2 database, and whenever you are installing NiFi, you cannot actually change H2 database to any other database as of now. So as of now, that feature is not there. And by default, that H2 database resides inside a database repository. So to check that, you can navigate to NiFi home directory and then navigate to database repository. Press ls -lrt command, and you can see here we have couple of H2 databases. One is NiFi user keys and the other one is NiFi flow audit. Okay, so in this video, we'll be trying to access this database. Now, in order to access this database, we have to have some kind of client which can connect to this database. So this H2 database is actually written in Java, so it supports JDBC client. So I have already done some research, and what I found is that we can download H2 graphical user interface client from this website, h2database.com. And inside that, go to the download section. So the latest stable release is this one. So I'm just going to download this one, this latest stable release, which is 1.4.199. And I'm going to download platform independent version. And if I click here, it will start downloading on this machine. I don't want to download this client here because my NiFi is on a different server. So I've just right click here and click on copy link address, and then I'll be copying this software in the home directory of this server where we install NiFi. So I'll type wget command and give this complete URL, and then it will start downloading. Let's do ls -lrt, and now we can see the download has successfully completed. Let's unzip it by typing unzip command, and let's clear the screen and do ls -lrt again. Now we see the folder has been extracted and a new folder H2 has been created. Inside that, the content has been extracted. So we can go to H2 folder, and inside that we have a folder called bin. So inside that we have a jar file which is called h2-1.4.199.jar file. So this is the one which we need to use to, you know, start that graphical user interface client in order to connect to H2 database. So I have also saved some of the information here in the notepad. Okay, one important thing which we need to do is whenever you start this client, it is by default not going to allow you to connect to this client from different remote system. So for example, if you have installed this on the same machine and if you are trying to access this web interface on the same machine, it will work. But if you try to access this interface on a different machine, it will not work. So in order for that to make work, you can set this h2.server.properties file in the home directory, and inside that you can write this line, web allow others equal to true. So I have already done this. I will show you what I have done. So if you go to home directory of this user and type ls -lrta, you will see a file which is .h2.server.property. This is the one which is created by me. So in fact, I'm just going to delete it and create this file again. We don't need to put anything other than this line, web allow others. So I'm just going to create this file again, and inside that we should be having this content. So there are many ways to create a file on Linux system. So the one which I'm going to follow is I'm just going to paste this string and redirect it to this file. that should do the trick. And if we do cat command, we should be able to see the content of this file. Okay, so this property is already set to web allow others to true. Now let's go back to that H2 bin directory and start the services. Now to start the services, the command which we need to type is this one. I have already copied it. So let's paste it here and hit enter. And it is saying services are started. So we should be able to connect to this service on port 8082. By default, this H2 graphical user interface client works on port 8082. And also, as you can see, this is showing here private IP, which is something which is accessible only on this machine. But I already have public IP for this machine, so I'm going to use that one. It is on the same machine where we have NiFi, so IP will remain the same. Only the port has changed. So this is the port which we need to access on. So once I do that, I can see this graphical, you know, client which can allow me to connect to NiFi H2 database. So in the setting name, I'm just going to give it some name. It can be any name. And in the driver class, we need to put this class org.h2.driver. In the JDBC URL, we need to give complete path of NiFi flow audit database. So this database is inside database repository directory. If you have installed the software on any other directory, just remember you need to give the complete path of this, you know, DB file. And in addition to that, there are other parameters which you need to store. So just you can copy paste this complete thing. And the username and password to connect to this audit database is NF. I have already seen this in the GitHub codes. So we should be able to use it. And now let's save this connection. And one weird thing is, once you click on save, the password goes away. So you need to retype the password and then click on test connection. So once we click on test connection, it shows test is successful, but the password goes away again. So let's put the NF again and let's click on connect. And then now we are in the interface, and if we type show tables and click on run, we should be able to see all the tables which are inside audit database. Now to see all the you know, columns and data inside one of the tables, we can simply type select star from along with the table name. Oops. So table name is action, and I'm going to click on run selected. And as you can see, it is successfully displaying us all the data. Guys, one thing which I did not show you is that we also need to change a property file of NiFi properties in order to make this thing work. So what we need to do is, by default, H2 database doesn't allow multiple applications to connect to database. So whenever you start NiFi, in the NiFi properties file, you know, NiFi.properties file, there are a set of properties written which actually describes how the NiFi software should behave. So if I do grep on this file with, you know, auto server keyword, you will see that this property is set to true in my case. But in your case, by default, it is set to false. So I had set it to true because I wanted other client to be able to connect to this database. So if it is not set to true, you will not be able to connect using this, you know, using this client with your NiFi database. And also, after you make the changes from false to true, make sure you restart NiFi instance. So you stop NiFi and start again, and then it should work. If you have any queries, feel free to write in the comment section. And if it is not working for you, please feel free to write in the comment section and let me know if you need any help. Thanks for watching.